All right, class, Professor R again, defense 101. When you're trying to get the puck out of your own zone, the number one thing is to make sure you get it by the blue line. If you get it past that line, the whole other team has to go all the way out of the zone to get it and bring it back in. It's how you prevent shifts in your own zone. It's pretty wise stuff, okay? Hey, Eric, Curtis, stop sleeping in my class, all right? This stuff is important. It's going to be on the test. And Pavel, stop eating your homework. What are you doing?
The reality of the Avs' defensive depth right now is that it's going to cost them some games until they get their healthy players back. And even in games where they should have won, if you get a goalie performance that's weak behind it, you're going to find ways to lose. Avs lose to the Anaheim Ducks 5-3. The first 35 minutes of this game was fantastic from Colorado. They played great hockey. Not perfect. They made some mistakes. One of them even cost them a goal. But on the whole, it was excellent, excellent work. In the first period alone, they outshot Anaheim 18-6. At one point in the game, shots were 30-10. Colorado was just relentless. They're simply able to grind out enough opportunities to get one to go in the first period.
After an initial quality opportunity where Mikko ends up hitting the post and it doesn't go the Avs' way, the Avs maintain possession in the zone. They work it around the perimeter. Eventually, this drops off to Makar. There's nothing too fancy here. Makar finds a lane, throws it to the net. They have Nieto and Compher in front, so they're able to get this puck through and find a good bounce. Credit to Compher here. This goes unrewarded because the puck doesn't touch him, but a nice job getting a stick lift in on his defender to allow this puck to roll free. That's what allows Mikko to get in and score this goal.
Sometimes the puck just seems to find the good players. Mikko finds that one, and the goal total keeps going up. Unfortunately, that first period lead barely lasts even 2 minutes before they give it back.
Ducks breaking out here. This is all pretty standard stuff. It ends up being essentially a 3-on-3, even a 4-on-3. The Avs have plenty of guys back as the Ducks enter the zone. The Avs play solid D. They get what is really a very limited shot from Vetrano from outside that comes in on Frankie, and Frankie gives up a pretty bad rebound here. It comes out hard and fast, and you see just bad tracking and coverage from Lehkonen. Sweeping across the ice, this is Lecky's guy. He needs to stick with him as Makar gave him up. You have the pick play. This is very standard hockey where the guy goes down the middle and takes the defenseman away. It's not really realistic for Makar to step up and through and cover this guy. This is why you have the third man back. He covers in late crossers like that. Lecky just doesn't get the coverage, and Frankie gets beat.
Every goal is multiple breakdowns through and through. A bad rebound and bad coverage by the Avs. It's never just one thing. But man, did Pavel Francouz not do himself any favors in this hockey game. So the Avs play a very good period outside of giving up that goal and one other breakaway opportunity that they gave up, and they don't really get rewarded. It's 1-1 after 1. Thankfully, they come out strong in the second period. They know they deserve better, and they keep playing strong and do get rewarded for it. When the Avs D is playing well, they're jumping up into the play, and honestly, at times, it's entirely undefendable.
When the Avs are playing well, you know you're going to see good forecheck pressure. This puck gets in, and Anaheim never even really has possession of it. Both Erod and Lecky just going to work in the corner, forcing a turnover that allows them to get this puck back to MacKinnon. And MacKinnon gets the entire Ducks hockey team puck watching. All five skaters, all looking at MacKinnon, all looking at the puck. No one paying attention to Sam Girard, sneaking in on the back door for a quality opportunity. And MacKinnon's so good, despite everyone watching his puck, he still finds a way to get this puck through the seam, and Girard finishes.
Great work by MacKinnon to get that across to Girard, but this was a fantastic game from Girard. Look, I'm certainly not in the camp of he's terrible and the Avs should trade him, but I am in the camp of he's capable of playing a lot better than he has over the past 3 weeks, month or so, and you saw that tonight. You got the A-plus version of Sam Girard, and it's really, really good. He doesn't have to be that good every night, but you'd like to see him get a lot closer to that a lot more regularly. And the Avs cap off this great stretch of quality hockey with a power play goal.
Nothing really to break down here. You've seen it a million times. This puck stays in the perimeter. This puck goes to Mikko for a one-timer. This puck goes in the net.
His shot is just way too good. And it's nice to see the Avs realizing that and regularly putting him in situations to utilize it more often. Now, some of that comes from the player too, but look, you have 34 goals and you're less than 50 games into the season. You're flying. So you're put in a situation where there's roughly 5 minutes left in the second period and the Avs are up by two. This is a game they should win. Certainly a game they should figure out a way to win against a weaker team like Anaheim. And unfortunately, they kind of completely fall apart. They stop pressuring at all, and they let Anaheim take over and control the game. Now, part of this is because of their weak defensive depth. They consistently struggled to get the puck out of their own zone in any way, shape, or form. They struggle to even ice the puck. That leads to long extended shifts, which leads to tired legs, which leads to goals against.
Multiple failed clears by Eric Johnson and Curtis McDermott have the Avs exhausted in their own zone, and it comes back to haunt them as this puck gets shot on net. It's nothing dangerous. Francouz makes the save, and EJ just completely fails to win a battle. He even has an assist from Cogliano at the start, and the Avs just completely fail to, honestly, they barely even touch the puck. That's the one time EJ gets any amount of stick on it. It's just exhausted, terrible hockey, and then this still shouldn't be in the net. Francouz should be able to seal that post pretty easily. In fact, he does on the first attempt, but he gets off of it, and it ends up trickling through him.
Yes. A long, terrible shift from your defense, that is a factor here, but there is no universe where an NHL goalie should let that goal go in. And the Avs play all of that good hockey and can't even carry the two-goal lead into the third period. Now they have a hockey game on their hands. And they get into that third period, and they treat it like they're still up two. They still don't pressure forward at all, and Anaheim pretty much does whatever they want. Despite that, the Avs actually survive for more or less the first half of the third period, which, I mean, okay, I don't really care how the bread gets made if they get the job done. The problem is they didn't get the job done. And we need to face a harsh reality here. Nothing against the guy. I'm sure he's an amazing dude. But the reality is, Curtis McDermott is just not an NHL caliber defenseman.
Dump in here from Anaheim. The puck gets rimmed around the boards. I'm not asking Curtis McDermott to win this foot race. I understand that's not his skill set, but I am asking him to play reasonable defense. And he just doesn't do that. He just floats all the way to the boards here, does not prevent the lane to the dangerous area of the ice, and gets absolutely abused for it. Just doesn't cover anything effective, and this leaves the Avs in a horrible situation, where now you have Brad Hunt trying to defend two players directly in front of his own net. A valiant job by Erod to try to get in and save this play, but he's a little late and just not strong enough, as Brad Hunt also can't bail out Curtis McDermott. He's not able to get in the passing lane effectively. The pass comes through. Henrique is able to get the finish.
It's just a brutal mistake that causes the entire play to break down from McDermott, and credit to Adam Henrique for being strong on his stick and finishing the play. I'll leave it at that with McDermott, and not on that play, but the bigger problem for Colorado's defense with the injuries that they have is that Eric Johnson is no longer reliable in any zone on the ice. And I hate that. I don't want to see that. It sucks all the way around, but he's just not a guy that you can consistently rely on. It's just the reality of where the Avs defense is at, and it's something that they're going to have to deal with for one more game, hopefully. Hopefully that's it. After the All-Star break, Manson should definitely be back, and hopefully Byram too. The defense is tough with that depth, because those guys are slamming into their ceiling. They're just not capable of playing that much better. Pavel Francouz, unfortunately, is capable of playing a lot better than he did in this game. And ultimately, his mistake ends up in the game-winning goal.
Nothing to really break down here either. The Ducks throw this puck through the neutral zone. They get a little bit of a decent bounce that they get to possess the puck and into the Avs zone, but the defense is fine here. It's effective. This is not a dangerous opportunity. It's a wrist shot from well outside the circles, and Frankie just misses it.
Again, a healthy Avs team with a better defense, maybe an extra forward or two, they survive this game. They survive a poor game from Pavel Francouz, but the Avs defense isn't good enough to help him out, and the Avs offense actually played pretty well tonight, but once they got down, John Gibson just made a couple of great saves and stopped them from getting that next critical goal. And I will give the Avs a little bit of credit. They did play quite well after they fell behind. They got themselves into gear, and against a weaker goalie, they almost certainly score. They created four or five grade A chances that somehow Gibson just gets a toe on or gets a little bit lucky and it hits him, and the Avs just couldn't get it to go. So they deserve a little bit of credit there, but all of that pretty much gets taken away because they never should have been in that place in the first place. The team as a whole has to play better, has to remain aggressive when they're playing with the lead. Certainly a one-goal lead you can't just sit back on and completely stop offensively. And yes, I get it. Your weak defenders often struggle to get you out of your own zone, and that's holding you back on offense at times, but it still has to be better. But really, you just need better from your goaltender. That's a game that's on Frankie. The big picture, they're 6-1 in their last seven. They have one more game going into the All-Star break. If they win the game against the Blues on Saturday, you're kind of chilling. You don't really think too much about this loss. But the Avs have already made a bit too much of a habit of giving away games that should have been 2 points. They can't keep doing it. That is the end of this game video review. Thank you for watching. Head on over to thednvr.com for all of our coverage. I am Rudo, and don't make me break out the professor again.